Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we will talk with examples three concepts: call, apply and bind in JavaScript. These are actually used at many places and these are like common questions in JavaScript. Okay, so first of all we'll talk about what call, apply, bind does and then we'll try to understand it. So call method calls a function with a given this value as an argument provided individually. So whatever this context which function already has, you can actually override it by passing the new this value. Same with apply. The only difference is in apply we are passing an array. Here we are passing a single argument. Okay, so let's see that in the example. Then only you will be able to understand that, okay, this is how it is working. So a simple example is this. We have a person and we are calling person.fullname, so it will be able to print first name and last name. What if I wanted to call this full name function by passing my own variation of this object so that I can print first name and last name with some different value? Okay, so let's say the same code is, this is clear, right? So I will just remove it and place it here. So I have my new object which has different value of first name and last name, and I wanted to call this function. So how we do a dot call is function name dot call. So person dot full name is a function name dot call, and here we are passing the replacement of this object so that the first name should be information technology and last name will be management. Okay, here we actually override the definition of this object in this context. So this is call. Now instead of this, like if you wanted to use apply, what you will do is you just pass the array as an argument in this case. So simple example for apply is just trying to find out a max in an array. So here we have numbers array and you wanted to pass it. You can directly pass it using triple dot, or you can do apply math.max.apply. Max is a function, so function name dot call, function name dot apply, and are you overriding this? No, I'm just passing the numbers. Okay, and if you talk about the bind is also a kind of a same flavor what we have. So if we just talk about overriding the person object in the last video, in the last example, so this is the person object and we are able to get the person dot full name, which will give us this dot first name last name. What if I wanted to override it? What if I wanted to override, I'm actually trying to bind. So my object is there, this is returning my object. I want to bind this with a different person object. Okay, so my object is person dot full name. So to get full name is my object dot bind person. So my object is explicitly, we are actually providing the person object inside it. Okay, and when you do the get full name, you will get the value. Okay, so bind we actually use where you want to inject properties inside a function which are not available there. So my object first name last name, and you are binding with the person object. So in that, these two properties will be available. Okay, bind is also used like in inner functions. You wanted to, there is no variable available, there is no this object available, so you explicitly bind those inner functions with the dot bind this. Okay, so this is simple call, apply, bind. So what bind does, bind methods a new function that when it's called has its this keyword set to the provided value. So if you see this, the bind functions create a new function that when called has its this keyword set to the provided value. So here what we are doing, bind with the person. So here in the my object, this will be replaced with this person object. Okay, this dot first name last name, if this person object has the first name last name, then this dot first name will point to this person object which you just passed. Okay, so Let's talk about closures and all other important aspects of JavaScript in coming videos.